Got him. Got him. Number four. Another slot.
What's up, everybody? Blue Gabe. We're here in Sandsprit Park in Stuart, Florida. I got Bree with me, BA Fishing on YouTube. Y'all are gonna definitely have to check her out, the paddleboard queen. She also does kayak fishing. Right now, I'm gonna turn this camera around, show you how she unloads these paddleboards by herself. What are you, like 100 pounds?
Soaking wet,
100 pounds, and these paddleboards are big. But these paddleboards will open you up to certain styles of fishing and certain places that you can go that you can't take a boat. So they're a pretty good tool if you ask me.
Who loaded these in the truck for you?
Me. It's a lot of fun.
Were you calling me fat or what? Y'all, she brought the big board out for me.
Big fish, 12 footer. Still lighter than a kayak.
Now, why do you have the skeg on one and not on the other one?
Because that one was sitting on top of that one in the truck.
Just go for it. You're gonna get wet anyways.
Winter.
It's winter.
It's so cold.
She's from Philly and she just said it's winter and it's 78 degrees.
What are those?
My very used anchor here.
Those anchors about drowning me on our last paddleboard video.
You're gonna love them on this one.
All right, now explain the thing that's around your waist.
It is a fanny pack.
Is that
supposedly,
no. Is that to carry your makeup?
Oh yeah, because I wear so much. It is my life preserver. So it's a belt pack. Everybody thinks I'm wearing a fanny pack. It's not, it's a life jacket.
You're from Philly, y'all wear fanny packs.
You're not talking about Philly.
Y'all check this out, look. I fight big gators, swim with sharks, and now she's got me out here in 8 foot of water wearing a life jacket. Whatever.
Y'all see that?
That's called a Yozeri Minner, and I'm about to whoop Bree with it.
But are you ready?
Ready, let's do this.
Y'all look at this palm tree little engineering I just did for my GoPro.
That is special. You're gonna have a way better view than me.
Whoa! Nothing like
that's risky.
That's risky.
That's a little risky right there.
Oh,
I'm putting I'm putting this camera up, guys, and you're gonna have to deal with the GoPro from here on out. It's a keeper. Yeah. Come here and video me. On a paddleboard, y'all, my second cast.
Oh my goodness. You are ridiculous. That is a slob. That is ridiculous.
On the paddleboard.
Heck yeah. Nice job.
I can't get him off though.
You need some pliers.
You guys, what do you think about that?
Heck yeah.
He's a slot.
Oh my gosh. Hey, you want to have snook tonight?
Yeah.
You guys, I just caught my first snook on a paddleboard on the Old Smoky. Favorite rods is where it's at. Y'all, this is controlled chaos.
Oh my goodness. I saw that thing come up. Looks like you got a good fish. There you go.
Now we gotta go. We don't even have a cooler. Ice, though.
We're trying to make it over here to shore to where there's a cooler, but y'all, I'm a boater. Like, this is how I just landed that fish. I have no idea. I want to get over here to the bank though, so we can pull my big camera out, get some good pictures, measure him on this cooler over here, and I'm pretty sure he's going to the house though. Yo, look at that, on the sup, as Bree would call it, on the sup. She's still healthy. We're gonna take her over here and measure her.
See?
Almost 30 inches, 29.
Heck yeah.
Is that a keeper?
That's a keeper.
I gotta check fish rolls, 20, y'all, but
28 to 32.
We got a slot.
Woo!
My second cast. I know these fish. I know where they live because I snorkel with them. Y'all have seen my videos. I went over there on the front of that blue boat and I saw that sandbar come down deep to a trough, pitch at Yozuri jerk bait, jerk, jerk, bam. Luckily though, she ran away from the poles and I ended up getting her. Most of the time they'll break you off. I outsmarted her today. Now it's Bree's turn, or mine. Hey Bree, guess what? I'm leading. Hey, we're gonna put these coolers.
I haven't even had a cast yet, okay?
We're gonna put this camera away and get back to fishing. Y'all see that light? Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Got one. Got one. What y'all think about that? Snook on the stand-up paddleboard. Number two, Bree, I don't know where you're at, but you better be catching them. I'm telling y'all, these, it doesn't even really matter the color with these Yozuri jerk baits. They just flat out work. I mean, I've fished my whole life. I don't get paid a dollar by this company. I don't even know anybody that works there. But if you guys are ever gonna believe me on anything, I'm gonna tell you when something works, and these jokers work. This Old Smoky, I've got 15 pound Power Pro on it. It's just a $99 rod and about $150 reel, I think. It's just a good, easy combo. Anytime you're fishing, the better you know an area, or the better you know situations as far as where bait stacks up, lights, sandbars that meet channels, sandbars that are flat and have a little narrow spot through them. Something that makes bait stack up will always have fish. Now, will you always catch them? No, but holy mackerel, there's some big waves hitting. Holy. But always try to be aware of your surroundings. Always try to fish areas that have a lot of fish in them. When you throw up against the dock, try not to hit. Number three. Oh, I come off. Oh no, he come off. Look at my last hook is bent. I just lost a nice one. Hey, all you can do is keep fishing. Got number three. Y'all, this is so much fun. Anytime you're dealing with a bait that has treble hooks in it, be careful, because if this fish shakes his head, he will wreck you. I had to get my pliers. What about number three on the stand-up paddleboard sitting down? What can I say? Ow! This is living life, y'all. Bree's one of my best friends. She loves these paddleboards. This is her passion. I'm just sharing it with y'all. Leave a comment below if you want to see us do more of these style videos, because to me, they're awesome. Right over my shoulder is that light that I was just targeting. I'm not throwing dead in the light. I'm throwing to the left and to the right of it just a little bit and jerking that bait into it. It's jerk, jerk, pause. Three fish in a row, just like that. So like I said before, you better cut that leader and put a new one on. I'm only cutting about 3 inches off. Retie them. Lures are expensive. You don't want to be going through a bunch of them because you didn't have time to retie. Got him. Got him. Number four. Another slot. Y'all see how I just stopped him with that rod? Oh, come off! No! Oh, that was a slot fish. I gotta straighten his back hook off. Oh my goodness. Y'all, that was a stud. Y'all see my cell phone, my big camera? For those of y'all that didn't think I really trusted this box, well, there it is, I do. This is so much fun. I'm telling you, so much fun. I'm really not upset that I have to stop right now, because that big fish just sort of blew that area up. So I can give it a couple minutes of a break, retie, regroup, and get ready to roll. Y'all, I want you to leave a comment below and tell me what's the next thing you want me to try to catch on a paddleboard. You gotta be realistic though, something that I could actually possibly do.
You guys, I'm hooked up. Oh, thank you. Oh my gosh, it's gonna get stuck in the anchor line. Oh, come here. Oh, smelly nasty. Oh, hello.
Find the camera. Like a keeper fish.
I don't know. Oh, he jumped right up on my board. Hello.
How are you doing?
No, I am though. Y'all, we were calling it quits and look what she just gone and done.
Yeah. This is gonna be surgery right here.
We were just getting ready to call it quits. I thought I filmed her fighting it, but looked down and I didn't have it on record. That's life.
No.
All right.
Oh, heck yeah.
You couldn't let old Blue Gabe out, do you?
Hey, but unfortunately, that's not going to make the cut to win tonight, because wait till you see my footage. Turn him loose right here between my legs.
All right.
Hold on. Let me get a close-up of that eyeball glowing. All right. Let her go.
Right. Yes.
Ding.
That's the best feeling ever. Gosh. Let's do that again. I need to redo this one.
For me to make her leave, I'm going to have to say, we have to leave, Bree. That's it. This is what I'm gonna have to do. Hey, somebody put a snook in your front seat. I'm gonna show y'all right now what type of person Bree is. Look at this, fishing rods, paddle boards. Now let's go to the inside. Let's go to the inside. Bow and arrow, coolers, cast nets, spear guns. Dive flag, shoes. You wear shoes?
Sometimes.
Let's go. All right, y'all, we're back at the house. Got one big fat snook. I'm not gonna reveal who won just yet, though. She's filming, so I don't wanna say anything. She might get mad, y'all. Actually, you've already seen it by now. Let's just get to cleaning the fish. Snook's just like any other fish. Come in, get right on their backbone. I'm trying not to do it too fast so I don't get scales all over everything. Now, I'm gonna tell y'all something right now. Captain Matt Budd and Jupiter, Bree, and most other people love snook. I am not a huge fan of it at all. But one thing about Bree, if you don't cook her dinner, she'll get pissed off. So we gotta eat. We gotta eat it. You do not cook snook with the skin on. They were called soap fish forever because if you cook their skin, it tastes just like soap. So I always leave just a little bit on the end so I can put my fingers on it and hold it. Done. They're not a very bloody fish at all. Probably, to be honest with you, it's gonna taste pretty good. I'm just not a huge fan of it. All right, well, I was gonna cook mushrooms and onions and she just informed me she didn't like them. So I'm gonna make a simple, easy meal. Look how pretty that, come here and show them how pretty that filet is. Just pretty white meat. But I'm gonna take this big chunk, set it aside, take a little bit of black pepper, a little bit of the garlic butter. I haven't used the garlic butter in a while. Flip it. A little bit of salt. Now, in this pan, I've got just regular bacon grease this time. So, let me just tell you the last 24 hours. We did the snipe video. I came home, spent all night getting that footage ready. Rico got here this morning, edited all day. Bree got here at 1:45. We ate the snipe. Then we went fishing, fished all the way till after dark because I had to force her to leave. Actually, she got her lure hung, so then we had to leave because she didn't have another one. Now we're cooking. I don't even have an appetite because right now when we get done eating, I got to go get a shotgun from my buddy, come home, sleep. Tomorrow morning, meet the owner of Ingle Coolers to do a charity shotgun sporting clay tournament. So I'm almost whooped, but the weekend's here. It smells good. I won't lie. To go with it, I just made some simple yellow rice and a piece of fish. That's it. Let's see what it looks like. Woo! I love cooking in bacon grease. All right, that is it. That bacon grease caramelizes it and makes it oh so good. All right, let's say the blessing. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for allowing me to put such a awesome beating on her today, fishing on the paddle boards. But in all honesty, thank you for just allowing us to have an awesome, safe day. Thank you for dying on the cross. Forgive us of our sins. Amen. All right, y'all. She is 400 hours away from being monetized on YouTube, and she has some of the coolest fishing videos there are. She's a chick, for one. That's awesome. Two, she's a chick that fishes. That's really awesome, and she does it all by herself, way offshore on paddle boards and on kayaks. Go watch her YouTube. What's your YouTube?
BA Fishing.
That is in B as in boy, A as in apple, fishing. There's actually two of them. She didn't know that. There's a guy and then there's her. Make sure you're checking out the hot chick, not the dude. It's BA Fishing with a girl.
This is so good.
You like it?
I love snook. This is really good. Mm-hmm.
We did say that winter had to cook.
It's good that you did.
I mean, you could have cooked me a Philly cheesesteak.
I'm not going to talk about that.
Redneck, where's your bite?
There you go. Oh, make up for the snipe.
All right, y'all, while I knew the fish was going to be good, I'm not hungry. I'm going to have a couple bites of hers, and I got to head over and get a shotgun so I can go shoot this charity event tomorrow, which I'm also making a video out of. As we always say, thanks for watching. Thanks for the shares. Please check out Bree's channel. Thanks for all the positive comments on mine. If you're reading them and you see some of those negative ones, just keep scrolling because we don't care about them. Hey, thanks for everything. But like Jake always says, we're getting the heck out of shape.